Hello from the Hemlock Grove of Lightspring Glen, where I am here not quite alone to make this recording, and I've been waiting out on this summer Sunday afternoon, which is usually when I make these videos for Summer Mondays with Mary. I've been waiting out the further into the woods, the dirt bike riding going on by my neighbors, and in some ways I think it kind of echoes a little of Mary's poem I'm about to share with you. So I shall not stand in too much ceremony and get started in case they come back a little too quickly. I'm hoping they're not. But it is a beautiful, beautiful summer afternoon, and it is a recording I'm making for the second Monday of August, even though last week when I recorded it, hope I'm not bouncing you around too much, I said in the video it was the second Monday. Well, now it is by the time this gets uploaded. So the poem Mary wrote was about going to the woods. It might be one you know. If not, I'm pretty sure you're going to like it. And the view you're seeing here is a downslope of this hill, Richardson Hill, on which I live. All right, Mary, what did you have to say about going to the woods? The title of the poem is How I Go to the Woods. And she says this. Ordinarily, I go to the woods alone, with not a single friend, for they are all smilers and talkers, and therefore unsuitable. I don't really want to be witnessed talking to the catbirds or hugging the old black oak tree. I have my way of praying, as you no doubt have yours. Besides, when I am alone, I can become invisible. I can sit on the top of a dune as motionless as an uprise of weeds until the foxes run by unconcerned. I can hear the almost unbearable sound of the roses singing. If you have ever gone to the woods with me, I must love you very much. The sun, one behind the clouds, just a little bit here, and it's the light of the afternoon sun I wanted to capture as well, but we'll leave it at that. Wishing you well for this second week of August. I will be back in a week. Take care.